healthy thyroid plays a huge part in your brain chemistry. So when you have an unbalanced thyroid, it's really common to suffer from mood changes. I know that this was something that I definitely had when I was going through Graves' disease, and then even after I had my total thyroidectomy. If you're new here, hello, my name is Emma and I suffered from Graves' disease for 4.5 years, and then I had a total thyroidectomy back in 2017. On this channel, I like to share with you all of the things that I have learned on my journey to health, and I just want to help you get through this time in your life as well. So when my thyroid was overactive, I definitely noticed changes in my mood and just how I felt. I was always tired and fatigued. When your thyroid's overactive, you can feel like panicked a lot of the time and anxious, especially when your heart's racing. It just makes you feel really agitated. That's something that I definitely felt. I was very irritable at times, and that's very unlike me. I'm normally quite calm and I don't really get angry easily. And I definitely had like crazy mood swings where out of nowhere, I just like get rage. That's like the only way I can kind of describe it. But things just would really irritate me, and then I would just like blow up and get really mad in ways that I wouldn't normally. It was really weird to feel like that, especially as someone who is quite calm most of the time. But I can tell you that once my levels like became in range, so when I went into remission, I didn't have the rage so much. The rage kind of only happened when I first got diagnosed. So when my hormones and levels and everything were completely out of whack, that's when that happened. But then I definitely did have the like nervous and anxious feeling throughout the whole time I had Graves. Even when I was in remission, I still had that like panicky, nervous feeling a lot. Another thing that really affected me the most was brain fog. I had no concentration, I couldn't retain information, and I would stumble over my words all the time. I was studying my personal training qualifications at the time, and I just could not focus. I couldn't do it. I couldn't do the course. It was so hard. I mean, I completed it in the end, but it took me way longer than it normally would have. And I just remember like in tears, just so upset because I just couldn't focus. I couldn't like read. My brain just wasn't functioning how it normally was. I lost my spark about me. As part of my course, I had to do, it was online, so I had to do all these online quizzes and read through all these notes, and then I had to plan and film like fitness sessions. And I was a dance teacher. I'd been teaching fitness and dancing for years and years. So this wasn't like a new thing to me. At the time when my brain was just so like muddled, I couldn't even do the basic tasks that I had been training and doing basically my whole life. Like I've been a professional dancer for so long. So to do something that normally comes so easily to me, to not even be able to like comprehend and plan what it was that I needed to do, it was so frustrating and hard. And that was definitely one of the hardest things that came with my thyroid imbalances. Then when I had my total thyroidectomy, it kind of went the opposite way. So when you have hyper, you're like really like alert and everything's like, you know, you're so panicky. Then when my thyroid got removed, I still was hyper for a couple of months, but then I did become hypo. When that happened, my moods got really low. So I wouldn't say I was suffering from depression, but I definitely had like those types of symptoms, like just feeling really low for no reason and just like unmotivated and really sluggish. And yeah, just really down. I know a lot of people can feel quite teary and do suffer from depression during that time. Even still, sometimes it happens to me. But when I am like that, I'm very aware that it is just because of my thyroid hormones. So I'm able to do things to make myself feel better, but that is something that you may experience. Obviously, if it's very severe, you should go and see help. And I always speak to my endocrinologist about these symptoms, and she does, you know, talk me through them. I understand that they are normal and they do come with thyroid disease. I think that helps me to kind of accept it, especially when you are feeling so low. It's such a horrible, you know, headspace to be in. So when I am feeling like that, I just kind of take a moment. I'm like, I'm okay. Everything's okay in my world. This is because of my hormones. And that seems to help me to feel a bit more settled during those times. Also meditation. I'm a huge fan of meditation. I meditated when I had Graves' disease, and it really helped me, especially in those moments when I was so heightened, you know, my nervous system and all my senses were just working so hard and fast. I would use meditation to calm myself down, feel centered, you know, just remind myself I'm okay, everything's okay. It's just my body is going through something at this time, and I still use that today. Every day I meditate 1 to 2 times a day, and it just helps me to stay centered and to really, you know, be connected to myself. I think the worst thing about all of that is when you don't have those problems and then they suddenly hit you so fast, like the brain fog and the short-temperedness, it can feel really overwhelming and confusing, especially for the people around you. If they don't, you know, they're not used to seeing you like this, and suddenly, you know, you're a bit cranky, you're really irritable, and you know, you've got that nervous feeling. I just truly think that unless you've gone through it, it's so hard to understand what it's like to live with these things. You have to experience it to really understand what it's like. So as someone that has gone through it, I just want to really put out the message that you're going to be okay. You can get through this. I know I did, with the help of my doctors and just really learning from my body. I really want to bring awareness to the different symptoms that you may be suffering from, and just to, you know, make it normal. We should be able to talk about these things. You shouldn't be suffering, you know, feeling all confused and not having support around you. That's why I really want this group here on YouTube to be nice and supportive for each other, where we can talk about these symptoms and not feel embarrassed, or, you know, have somewhere to connect with other people who are also going through this. I hope you found this video helpful. I'm currently filming a series, I guess it is, of all the different symptoms that I went through, so I can try and help even at least just one person get through this. So if you have any videos you would like me to make or topics you want me to cover, please leave a comment down below and I'll definitely get to it. I really wish you all the best and just so much health and happiness on your healing journey. And please check out my other videos and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye, have a wonderful day.